Hi, oceanography students. One of the things we're going to be doing in lab is looking at the surface currents of the world, these big loops of water that we call the major subtropical gyres of the world. You can see that in all of the ocean basins, the water forms a kind of a big circle or a loop, and the word gyre literally means circular. And there's five of them in the world's oceans, the North Pacific, the South Pacific, the North Atlantic, South Atlantic, and then the Indian Ocean. And you can see that the gyres north of the equator, the water goes clockwise. And in the gyres south of the equator, the water goes counterclockwise. And the reason for that is pretty straightforward. It has to do with the direction that the wind blows. The wind is what's pushing the water around. Along the gray arrows on this diagram show us the direction of the prevailing winds. And near the equator, we have what are called the trade winds, or the equatorial easterlies, which blow primarily from east to west, like the arrows. Winds are always named from the direction they go from, and so winds that go from east to west are called easterlies. And then in the mid-latitudes, we have what we call the prevailing westerlies, which go from west to east. And then in the polar regions, we have these other winds called the polar easterlies. But the trade winds and the mid-latitude westerlies are the most important ones for moving the ocean currents. And because of the wind, the water's forced into those circles. It doesn't really have any choice in the matter. That's the way the wind pushes it. The trade winds push the water west along the equator. When it hits land, it turns away from the equator and eventually is then picked up by the westerlies that push it back across the ocean. And then the loop is completed by the cold current that flows back to the equator along the east side of the ocean basins. Now, each of those is a continuous loop of water, but it's useful for us to be able to organize things by naming them all. So make sure you memorize all these names, because there's going to be a quiz in lab. Just kidding. The gyre that's most important to us is the one in the North Pacific, which is part of what our coastline is on. And it consists of these four currents that that gyre forms that loop. And interesting that there's this other little current here called the Alaska Current, which actually flows counterclockwise up here. The North Pacific Current kind of splits, and some flows north up to the Gulf of Alaska. And most of it flows south as part of the California Current, where it joins the North Equatorial Current and becomes the Kuroshio or Japan Current along the coast of Japan, and then flows back across the Pacific as the North Pacific Current. Now, you might wonder, how do we know about the way these currents go? And there are a number of different things we can use to study them. And this, by the way, is just a figure from your book that shows the same thing. There's that Alaska Current there, and then the bigger loop of the North Pacific Gyre. And one way that we can study these currents is to take advantage of mishaps. Every now and then a freighter has an accident or runs into a storm and spills a bunch of shipping containers overboard. Shipping containers are big metal boxes that carry huge amounts of goods across the oceans. And the odds are good that the clothes on your back and the shoes on your feet and a lot of the things in your house, like your TV and your computer, spend some time in one of these big metal boxes, because they probably came here from Asia, which is how goods get here. Well, every now and then a freighter has an accident and material spills overboard, and when we have stuff that spills into the ocean of human origin, we call it flotsam, literally floating material, flotsam. And it might be little rubber duckies and children's toys or Nike shoes or any kind of thing that might float, and that stuff floats around and follows the ocean currents. Well, there's a guy named Curtis Ebesmeyer, an oceanographer, and he's made a science of studying flotsam. And he's even written a book about it. These little rubber duckies here, they last for years as they float around the oceans, and you can use them to track ocean currents. And Ebesmeyer's book is called Flotsametrics, flotsam being floating debris and metrics being to measure. So he's using floating debris to measure ocean currents and track ocean currents. And you're going to use some of Ebesmeyer's data in lab. A couple of decades ago, a bunch of shoes spilled off of a freighter in the North Pacific, and the way those shoes washed up on land allows us to reconstruct the circulation of the North Pacific Gyre. So I hope you enjoy your day in lab, and you can now use the information here to answer the questions in your pre-lab exercise.